ACCIS is the Advanced Composite Centre for Innovation and Science. Our aim is to develop the next generation of leaders and innovators in composite science and technology. Within ACCIS, we have the opportunity to offer you projects that run from the across the dimension scales, from the small scale, working at the molecular scale, underpinning science and chemistry, all the way through to small structural components, and all the way through to much larger components. So interdisciplinarity is what this is all about, being able to work in projects that involve engineering and other sciences to broaden the appeal of the work you do and make it very applied in some areas, but at the same time, potentially very fundamental. As an industrialist, how do you interact with ACCIS? Well, the CDT, we offer two project calls every year, and these are both in the form of short projects or as longer PhD projects. If you have an interest in working in more fundamental projects or more applied projects, then we can offer a whole host of subjects that will cover the range of dimension scales and range of different sort of levels of application. Just contact us, we have a whole host of students who are really keen and eager to get involved on those projects.
I am currently working on a recyclable composite material, or at least a process that can use recyclable materials and make a product that is intrinsically recyclable. It's basically trying to take recycled carbon fibres, taking this unaligned mess that you can't really do anything with, to recreate a material that is just as good in its performance as a virgin material, except that it's a fraction of the cost and you can reuse it.
This is a honeycomb, and this is kind of the focus of my work. We use these a lot in aerospace engineering because they're very light and very stiff.
My PhD is about using Kirigami with engineering sheet materials. Kirigami is origami, but you can cut as well as fold. And using Kirigami to create structures which can change their shape and adapt to different situations. Let's say you have an airplane wing. You want it to be able to perform well when the airplane is flying straight and level, but you also want it to perform when it's taking off and landing, and there are different requirements for that. So this is the sort of finished product. And if we squeeze this all up, then we have the same sort of honeycomb geometry that we saw earlier. But the novelty in my work is that we have not bonded it. We're leaving the structure flexible so that it can change shape. And this structure can form a cylinder because we're just bending these little bridges in between and bending the fold lines. So leaving the folds in the structure really affects the mechanical properties.
I'm working on ways of getting morphing structures triggered by temperature change. Basically, we want to find better ways of having variable geometry structures in aerospace change their shape without needing to be told to do so. So you have lots of bits inside jet engines where a designer wants this shape for low temperature and that shape for high temperature, but he can't have both, so we pick something in between. But now maybe we can have both, and we tune it with temperature change. The basic idea of how these work is you stick two layers of material together. One has a low thermal expansion coefficient, so it doesn't really expand or contract all that much. The other one has a high thermal expansion coefficient, so when you heat it up, it expands quite a lot. When you stick them together, one wants to expand, the other wants to contract, and the result is that it just curls over to the side. It's very much like what makes paper curl when you stick a sweaty palm of your hand on it. It's what makes curly leaf parsley curly. It's a phenomenon that we see in our everyday lives, but we don't really think much about it until we start to really dissect the fundamental mechanics of it.
I'm looking at using two of the rapidly growing technologies, virtual reality and motion tracking. I'm trying to use these technologies for skills training within composite manufacturing. The most used manufacturing process at the moment is called hand layup. It's a very complicated process which requires a highly skilled and experienced workforce. So I'm trying to design this training aid which could alleviate some of the problems that lie within this hand layup process. So I'm trying to combine these two technologies together and provide a very user-friendly system that both expert and novice laminators can use. So even the novice laminators can now just come outside the clean room and just wear this piece of goggles and voila, everything is ready to go and you're learning how to do these things in virtual reality.
currently the predominant process for making a composite part is manual, and it's reliant on craftsmanship. My research is looking at kind of how these parts can either be made better or designed better. I've worked with the laminators to design a standardized handheld tool. This is, I guess, a prototype for a standardized manufacturing tool to be used by laminators. And it's called the Dibber. It's just a simple handheld tool, a point to form corners, a flat edge to form flat surfaces, and these two curved features to form internal radii.
I'm Alex Brinkmeyer, and I'm a KTP associate at Oxford Space Systems. What we have here is a telescopic boom structure. So this is formed by several sections which are slotted together. And this deployable structure is driven by a coiled actuator, which uncoils and pushes the boom upwards. And it can extend to up to 2 meters. So this provides a very lightweight and cost-effective solution. And also, it completely complies with space requirements in terms of materials.